Hi, I am Dr. Mahesh Shah, an interventional cardiologist practicing in Mumbai. Two new ADP receptor antagonists or P2 vital receptor antagonists have been trying to compete with the clopidogrel in the management of acute coronary syndrome. Ticagrelor and prasugrel both are found to be superior in terms of platelet inhibition. The corollary of this would be that we expect that the cardiovascular events, adverse cardiovascular events, should come down with the higher antiplatelet efficacy. And we would also expect there is a potential for worsening of bleeding complication. It has to be proven in terms of trials whether in real clinical scenario whether this higher antiplatelet efficacy is beneficial or not. Recently, there are three large landmark trials, PLATO, TRITON TIMI-38 and Triology ACS trials. These three trials try to look at the different aspects of the role of antiplatelet agent in ACS management. Regarding the role of prasugrel in ACS management, in ACS patients who are being managed interventionally, we have a clear mandate in terms of TRITON TIMI-38 trial, which showed a clear superiority of prasugrel as compared to clopidogrel in patients who underwent angioplasty with stenting. There it was shown that prasugrel clearly reduced the incidence of major adverse cardiac events in terms of cardiovascular death, myocardial infarction and stroke with a slight increase in the bleeding, resulting in a net clinical benefit. But 40% to 60% of the patients all over the world are being treated medically and they do not undergo intervention. Now, in this group of patients, what is the role of prasugrel vis-a-vis clopidogrel was assessed in Triology ACS trial. And in Triology ACS trial, it was shown that overall as a group, prasugrel was not superior to clopidogrel in terms of reducing the primary endpoint or major adverse cardiovascular events. It was also shown that prasugrel was far more effective in terms of platelet inhibition by Verify now P2Y12 assay, but this did not result in a clinical benefit. Also, it was not found to have any additional bleeding risk. Bleeding risk was statistically not significantly different between clopidogrel and prasugrel. Thus, this trial clearly shows that in ACS patients managed medically, prasugrel has no superiority, and if it doesn't have a superiority, there is no reason for me to change from clopidogrel to prasugrel in this group of patients. But the trial and its sub-analysis throws a lot more questions than it answers. Some interesting and fascinating analysis has been done in the trial. It showed that though the incidence of first major cardiovascular event was not significantly different, but recurrent ischemic events were less with prasugrel as compared to clopidogrel. And there is a time dependent benefit of prasugrel. After 1 year, the major adverse event or primary event rate was less with prasugrel as compared to clopidogrel, and recurrent ischemic event was much lower after first year. Also, the incidence of heart failure was less with prasugrel as compared to clopidogrel, probably related to reduced number of recurrent ischemic events. How do I choose antiplatelet agent in patients with acute coronary syndrome? Acute coronary syndrome patients who are destined to go for intervention after angiography, I would prefer to put them on prasugrel based on TRITON TIMI-38 trial. The patients who are not likely to undergo intervention, medically managed ACS patient, the choice is between ticagrelor and clopidogrel. Ticagrelor has shown superiority over clopidogrel in patients managed medically, as shown in PLATO trial in the non-invasive arm. While ticagrelor is far more expensive, and in Indian patients, where many times patients, they are not very particular about taking their medicines, they might skip the dosages for variety of reasons and beliefs. To me, in this kind of unreliable patients, ticagrelor would be a bit risky, because antiplatelet withdrawal is known to precipitate acute coronary syndrome. So my choice in a patient who does not afford ticagrelor or who is unreliable to take ticagrelor regularly, I would be putting them on clopidogrel. Based on Trilogy ACS trial, medically managed patient, clopidogrel is as good as prasugrel. I would rather not take the risk of additional risk of bleeding which occurs with prasugrel. Nevertheless, in some group of patients, say for example where I am suspecting clopidogrel resistance, if somebody who was already on aspirin and clopidogrel and develops an acute coronary syndrome, or somebody who had an incidence of stent thrombosis previously when he was on aspirin and clopidogrel, or somebody where I have done platelet function assay and I find that there is a possibility of clopidogrel resistance, I would put them on prasugrel. Another subgroup of patients who are likely to undergo a bypass surgery, or the group of patients where they are likely to require non-cardiac surgery within a few months of ACS, I would like to put them on ticagrelor because it is easily and rapidly reversible molecule. Cardiovascular disease are the cause of the maximum number of mortality in any statistics, may it be developing countries or developed countries. The incidence of cardiovascular disease is increasing. It's very important to prevent mortality. Dual antiplatelet agents go a long way in preventing mortality in cardiovascular disease. We should not forget the mortality reducing benefit of lifestyle modification, regular exercise, maintaining ideal body weight, and the benefit of other pharmacological agents like ACE inhibitors, beta blockers, and not to forget the statins. Maintaining target blood pressure and target hemoglobin A1C or target sugar levels also goes a long way in preventing cardiovascular mortality.